Hello. Did you watch Just Sharing yesterday? If not, you might want to watch it first, because this is a follow-up to yesterday's sharing. This is Tom Lara, and I'm just sharing. Yesterday, I shared with you another struggle we had with our children, which was teaching them not to be selfish, but to be selfless. And I shared with you two reasons why we are selfish based on our experience with our children. So today, I want to follow up on that sharing by looking at this question, how to overcome our selfishness. And I believe there's only one sure way to overcome selfishness, and that's by being generous. And when I say generous, I mean being exceedingly generous. As Proverbs 21 verses 25 to 26 tells us, there are two kinds of people in our world today: the lazy person and the righteous person. And this is what it says. Lazy people who refuse to work are only killing themselves. All they do is think about what they would like to have. The righteous, on the other hand, however, can give and give generously. The lazy person, the selfish person, all he thinks about is what he would like to have, whereas the righteous person is giving generously. You see, we live in a world where it's natural to be selfish, to want more and more of everything. We are never content on what we have, but rather we desire for more. We want that promotion so we can earn more money. We want to be the best so that we get the recognition. Now, don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with wanting more. But the question is this: at what expense do you pursue more of everything? You see, there's nothing wrong with wanting to earn more money, but if it is at the expense of spending time with your family or your relationships, then you need to ask yourself if this is worth it, or is it plain selfishness and greed? We want to be the best to get recognition, but if it is at the expense of putting down others or stealing from others to get that recognition, then we need to ask ourselves if this is worth it, or is it plain selfishness and greed? A Jesus follower, on the other hand, is a person who gives more and gives generously. A person with a generosity mindset, because he believes that it's more blessed to give than to receive. And that's why he gives generously. But to be that kind of person, to be that kind of Jesus follower, we need what St. Paul said in Romans 12, verse 2. He said this: do not conform yourself to the standards of this world, but let God transform you inwardly by a complete change of your mind. Then you will be able to know the will of God, what is good and is pleasing to him and is perfect. We need a complete change of mind, from selfishness to generosity. And only then will we be able to overcome our selfishness. So let me ask you this: what kind of mindset do you have about generosity? We can have different kinds of mindset about generosity, but what kind of mindset do you have? Here are three mindsets about generosity. The first one is this: the Philip mindset. Do you have a Philip mindset? The Philip mindset is one that always thinks there is not enough and I need more. We need more. Remember the story in John's Gospel, chapter 6, the feeding of the 5,000? Jesus asked Philip, where can we buy food to feed everyone? And what was Philip's response? He doesn't respond by telling Jesus where. He says, for everyone to have even a little, it would take more than 200 silver coins. to buy enough bread. In other words, there's not enough money to feed them, so send them away. It's the scarcity mindset. The second kind of mindset is this, the Boaz mindset. Boaz was a rich landowner. You remember him? The story of Ruth and Boaz. Boaz was a rich landowner. And what he would order his workers at the end of the day was to leave some grain at the edge of the field. Why? So that those who are struggling, like the widows and the poor of that time, and those who are hungry can come and take the leftover harvest as a gift from Boaz. It was an acknowledgement that God had blessed him with so much that he wants to bless others. But you see, the Boaz mindset is a good one, but there is a big difference with the third mindset. Because the Boaz mindset is giving from the leftover, from what was left over of the harvest. Whereas the third mindset is greater than the Boaz mindset. The third mindset is the Abel mindset. And I hope this is what you aspire for. The Abel mindset is one that honors God with the first fruits of his labor. And that's why God honored Abel more than Cain. Because Abel gave the first fruits of his harvest, while Cain gave from what was left over from his flock. Abel gave from the first fruits of his harvest because he recognized that in God's kingdom, there is way more than enough. As Proverbs 3 verses 9 to 10 says, it says this, honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. You see, when we honor God and we put him first with what he entrusts to us, our barns will be filled to overflowing. That's his promise. And I hope you'll keep this in mind, that God always wants to be first in your life. As Jesus said it in Matthew chapter 6, he said this, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Seek him first. At the start of your day, put God first by seeking him in his word and talking to him in prayer. At the start of the week on a Sunday, seek God first in the Eucharist. And you will see selfishness slowly disappear from your life. I hope this challenges you to have the mindset of Abel, putting God first in everything. Let me pray for you now. Heavenly Father, I pray for every person who's watching this video right now, and I pray, dear Lord, that you would just give them the Abel mindset to put you first in everything, Lord God, in their life, in their relationships, Lord God, in their finances, Lord. Father, I pray that you would also provide for all of their needs. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for watching once again, and I hope, as I said, that this helps you and this challenges you to become an Abel. And again, I invite you to please follow me on Facebook and subscribe to me on YouTube and put some comments. Thank you and have a wonderful day, a wonderful weekend. God bless you.